أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
والليل إذا يغشى.
By the night when it covers.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والليل إذا يغشى. By the night when it covers the whole world and shrouds in darkness.
والنهار إذا تجلى.
And by the day when it appears.
والنهار إذا تجلى. And by the day when it shines and brightens.
وما خلق الذكر والأنثى.
And by He who created the male and female.
وما خلق الذكر والأنثى. And by Him who created the male and the female. Or by the male and female and the way He created them. This ayah, as I told you twice in Surah Al-Shams, this can be translated in two ways. Now there are two sets, day, night, opposing each other. In the same way, male, female, different, opposite sexes. In the same way, in nasayakum lashatta. The result of what you are doing is going to be different. Everybody is striving and working hard from morning till evening. Someone is, when he returns home in the evening, in addition to being tired and exhausted, he has brought a big load of sins also with him. A big load of divine chastisement also. The other one is, he also labored and worked, but he brought home forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the exact translation of a hadith. The Prophet says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kullu nafsin yaghdu. Every human being, when it is morning for him, till evening, فَبَايِعُ النَّفْسَهُ. He sells himself. Someone is selling his physical energy working. Someone is selling his mental faculty, his intelligence, some technical know-how, and so on and so forth. You are selling yourself from morning till evening. كُلَّ نَفْسٍ يَغْدُو فَبَايِعُ النَّفْسَهُ. But the result is different. Someone comes home with a big load of sins also. He remained involved in haram, in interest, in usury, in gambling, in telling a lie, and this thing and that thing. And someone comes home, mu'taquha. He has got his neck freed from the fire of the hell. So these are the two destinations to which you can go.
إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى.
Indeed, your efforts are diverse.
إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. This is مُقْسَمْ عَلَيْهِ. On which, you know, these three ayat of oaths, they prove. Just as the difference in the day and the night, وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَخْشَى وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّى. And the difference between the male and the female, وَمَا خَلَقَ الزَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْسَى إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. Now this is the most important place in the Quran. Now this, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. As I told you last night, it's like a flower bud. The petals are closed. Here now it is opening. The flower is opening up. And three petals appear of each flower. One is the flower of doom. The other is the flower of salvation.
فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى.
As for he who gives and fears Allah.
أَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى. As for him who gives his wealth in charity. This is the most fundamental. In Surah Al-Balad we saw, this is the narrow, you know, passage narrow valley which we have to cross. This is the bottleneck. فَلَقْتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَةِ مَا بَعَدْرَاكَ مَلَقَبَةِ فَكُّ رَقَبَةِ اَوْ اِتْعَامٌ فِي يَوْمٍ زِي مَسْقَبَةِ يَتْغِيمًا زَا مَقْرَبَةِ اَوْ مِسْكِينًا زَا مَتْرَبَةِ ثُمَّ كَانَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنَ even is based on a moral sense within human beings. أَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. You have a moral sense in you, a moral law according to Kant, you know. He said there are two proofs of the existence of God. The starry heavens above and the moral law within. This moral law, we read this last night. This moral law. فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. This knowledge and this distinguishing, this faculty, this ability to distinguish this is good, this is bad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has endued each human soul. So if this moral sense is active and this moral sense is active and alive, so he himself shuns away from evil, tries to do whatever he can do good. This is the basic meaning.
وصدق بالحسنى.
And believes in the best reward.
وصدق بالحسنى. This is on top. And then he truthfully testifies to whatever is good. This is the third faculty. You should be ready to accept anything. When somebody presents you something and you think it's good, accept it. Somebody says, brother, you are wrong here. What you are doing or what you believe is wrong. Now you argue with him. And during this argument, you come to feel what he is saying is correct. Now jump at it, accept it. Now if you feel, oh, then I will be defeated. So I'm not going to give in. This ta'assub, zid, this closes the door of goodness for you. But if all these three basic qualities are there, you are saved from the love of wealth, so that ita, you are giving, you are spending your wealth for the benefit of fellow human beings. And there you have an active moral sense within you. That moral law within, according to the words of Kant, is active. And number three, you have the habit to accept from whosoever it is coming. Even if it is coming from your enemy. But if your enemy says something correct, you accept it. Okay, brother, here you are correct. I accept. Let us proceed further. This point you have made. If all these three faculties are joined in a human personality, he becomes Siddiq. Note it. We have read in Suratul Nisa, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. Four levels of people who are mun'am alayhim, who are blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Topmost, Anbiya. Number two, Siddiqeen. Number three, Shuhada. Number four, the righteous, common righteous believers. They don't have any special achievement, but they are righteous, God-fearing, doing good deeds, but no extra achievement. But if somebody rises, there is a level of shuhada. Higher up is Siddiqeen. And next to Siddiqeen is Nabuwa. This last one is closed. Even before it was God given, it couldn't be attained by your effort. It was Wahhabi, not Kasbi. But The remaining two are there open to you. And these remaining two, if you want to have an insight, because in Surah Al-Hadid also we read, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الصِّدِّيقُونَ وَالشُّهَدَاءُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. These two levels are mentioned over there also. They refer to two types of psychological built of the personalities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made different, you know, aptitudes. Some people, in the modern psychology, they call them the introverts, always thoughtful, thinking. Then they have good sentiments. They would like to be alone, not in the company. Alone to themselves. They are not very active. They are not visible, running and going there or going here. Not very talkative. Introverts. Inside them. As Iqbal says, apne man mein doob kar pa ja suraghe zindagi. They are diving deep into their own selves. And the other is the extroverts. Their attention is toward the outside world. Enjoying, seeing, going here, going there, talking in the company. They are very, you know, very comfortable in the company. But when they are alone, they feel uncomfortable. But they are active because they are extroverts. So the first category from this come up the Siddiqeen. Abu Bakr was the Siddiq Akbar. Usman Ghani was the second Siddiq. This is a category. But the second category, who fail at the third level, Saddaqa bil Husna. This third quality is not very deep in them. So they take time. They take their time to understand. Umar took 6 years to understand what Muhammad is saying. Hamza took 6 years. But they were active. They were wrestlers. They were fighters. When they entered the fold of Islam, Islam got strengthened. So these are shuhada. More active, visible, more effective. But closer to the Anbiya are the Siddiqeen. That is why Imam Razi has said that this surah is the surah of Abu Bakr. And the next surah to Duha and Inshira, they are the surahs of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Surah Al-Layl, Surah Abu Bakr. Surah Al-Duha, Surah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى.
We will ease him toward ease.
فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. We shall gradually make him more and more able and suitable to reach the place of greatest ease, and that is the garden of paradise. If you have these three qualities, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you gradually, 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 nearer, 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 nearer to the garden of paradise. But if you have the three opposite qualities,
but as for he who withholds and considers himself free of need,
whosoever is miserly, he loves wealth more than anything. Vastagna. And he pays no care. La ubali. Fala ubali. I don't care. They don't feel for others. They have taunted on somebody. And you don't think that that I have hurt his feelings. No. What to me? I don't care. All these type of people. The reverse of attaqa. The moral law is very weak within themselves.
وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى
and denies the best reward.
وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى when something good, some truth is presented before them, they deny it. Although their heart has accepted, it is correct. وَاسْتَيْقَنَتْهَا أَنفُسُهُمْ in their hearts they believed. But with their tongues, they be right. So this is the just the opposite. Whosoever has all these three is the worst of the people. And the model of this character in that Arabian society of the time of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, society of Makkah, was Abu Lahab. The top there is Abu Bakr. The top there is Abu Lahab. In between you will have grades. Grades of the believers, grades of the disbelievers. Among the disbelievers were Abu Jahl, but Abu Jahl was not miserly. This was not real. He's above that. We shall read that surah. Which we may call the Surah of Abu Jahl. But he didn't have that moral law. Number two, he didn't have the ability to accept the truth when it comes to him. So he failed. But he was not miserly. So you will find others between these two extremes. So you will find in the Surah two words, Ataqa and Ashqa. Ataqa, topmost muttaqi, ashqa, the lowest wicked, the lowest in wickedness.
سَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى
we will ease him toward difficulty.
فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى whosoever has these three qualities, we shall gradually make him more able and suitable to reach the place of greatest distress. That is the fire of hell.
وَمَا يُغْنِي عَنْهُ مَالُهُ إِذَا تَرَدَّى
and what will his wealth avail him when he falls?
وَمَا يُغْنِي عَنْهُ مَالُهُ إِذَا تَرَدَّى and his wealth shall not be able to avail him of anything when he will be thrown headlong into the hell.
إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا لَلْهُدَى
indeed, incumbent upon us is guidance.
إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا لَلْهُدَى verily, it is our responsibility to show the path. To give guidance is our responsibility. And we discussed three levels of this guidance. One is the instinctive guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to everything. The ant knows how she has to live, how she has to feed herself. The bee, the honey bee knows everything. How she has to go to the flowers and collect and suck, you know, and then how to deposit the honey. This is guidance. Allah sent revelation or wahi to the honeybee. So instincts, they are also guidance. Man has also instincts. There is the guidance. Number two, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon man the ability that he can differentiate by himself between evil and good. فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَى with these two things we have come in this world. We have come here not blind. Allah has given us these two faculties. But then the final guidance comes through the word of Allah, which is transmitted to humanity through, number one, the Rasul-e-Malak, to a chosen person from among the human beings, Rasul-e-Bashar, and that is the link of Risala. And this is the final guidance. إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا لَلْهُدَى. Yes, this is our duty.
وَإِنَّ لَنَا لَلْآخِرَةَ وَالْأُولَى.
And indeed, to us belongs the hereafter and the first life.
وَإِنَّ لَنَا لَلْآخِرَةَ وَالْأُولَى. But then, we hold the total authority of Akhira as well as the Ula, the hereafter as well as this world. We don't share our authority with anybody else. This world is running according to our command. And we shall judge people on the day of judgment. لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ. So,
فَأَنذَرْتُكُمْ نَارًا تَلَظَّى.
So I have warned you of a fire which is blazing.
فَأَنذَرْتُكُمْ نَارًا تَلَظَّى. Now the Prophet is saying, صلى الله عليه وسلم, so my community, my people, I have warned you of the fire of flames.
لا يصلاها إلا الأشقى.
None will enter to burn therein except the most wretched one.
لا يصلاها إلا الأشقى. None will enter it but the most wretched. Why the most wretched? The highest level of guidance has been completed on Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. So those people who are not accepting it, even from Muhammad, they are the worst.
الذي كذب وتولى.
Who had denied and turned away.
الذي كذب وتولى. Who belies the truth and turns away.
وسيجنبها الأتقى.
But the righteous one will avoid it.
وَسَيَجَنَّبُهَا الْأَتْقَى. Far removed from it will be the most cautious, God-fearing and conscientious person. And who is he? Abu Bakr. أَتْقَى.
الَّذِي يُؤْتِي مَالَهُ يَتَزَكَّى.
He who gives from his wealth to purify himself.
الَّذِي يُوْتِي مَعْلَهُ يَتَزَكَّى. Who goes on giving his wealth to purify his self. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. He spent everything. His capital when he accepted Iman on the call of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, 40,000 dinars. Spent everything, each and every penny. And when he was going for Hijrah, accompanying Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whatever was there in the home he took, left nothing for his family. The father, he was blind person, Abu Qahafa, he embraced Islam only after the victory of Makkah. He came, asked the granddaughters, Aisha and Asma, رضي الله تعالى عنهما. Has Abu Bakr gone? Yes, Baba Jan, gone. Has he left something? Yes. And they gathered some pebbles, you know, in a handkerchief, and said, yes, this is the money that he has left. And he, you know, because he was blind, touched with the hands, okay. But there was not a single penny left. All the money he had already spent purchasing the slaves who embraced Islam and were being tortured one by one, six. And whatever price their masters demanded, he paid. Bilal was number one, Abu Fakih number two, Zunaira, a concubine, and so on.
الَّذِي يُوْتِي مَعْلَهُ يَتَزَكَّى. وما لأحد عنده من نعمة تجزى.
And not giving for anyone who has done him a favor to be rewarded.
وما لأحد عنده من نعمة تجزى. And it is not in recompense for a favor done to him by anyone. If he is doing some good to somebody, not because he had done some good to him. No, no. He doesn't have any burden of any good done to him by anybody else, which he has to repay. No, no.
إلا ابتغاء وجه ربه الأعلى.
But only seeking the countenance of his Lord, Most High.
إلا ابتغاء وجه ربه الأعلى. He is spending all this for nothing but to get to seeking the pleasure of his Lord, the Most High.
ولسوف يرضى.
And he is going to be satisfied.
فلسوف يرضى. And definitely he will be pleased. Now this goes both ways. He, who? Allah will be pleased, and also he will be pleased. رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه.